Well, the program is about learning whatever you want into a deeper thinking research thing.
Explain a little bit about the topic you selected and why you selected to research that topic.
The topic I selected about is hydraulics, and it is one of the newest topics of science I learned 6 months ago when I made this project. And so I just picked this project because it just looks interesting, like with all the liquids moving around. I was curious about this topic, so that's why I chose this topic. Well, I did an interview with Stephen Richmond, and I also use a lot of websites and a few books to like help me research this part. Well, the research process, first I needed to figure out what questions I wanted to ask. Then once I got those questions, then I went to try to find the answers. And when I got the answers, then I wrote them down. Once I wrote down all the answers, then I started putting things together into that website over there.
Okay, so you mentioned a website. Is that one of the products that you
Yes,
developed?
The website is one of the products.
And?
The hydraulic robotic arm. So one of them was, how does hydraulics play a role in life? And why do some urban areas use hydraulics, but other urban areas do not use hydraulics? This is a hydraulic robotic arm. Now, each lever you push and pull to make it work in different ways, because each lever is connected to a different part of the arm. Now, the green one moves the base. The red one lowers and rises the framework right here. The yellow one rises and lowers only the front part of the framework right here, and the blue one opens and closes the claw. When you combine all of them together, then you can pick up objects. Okay, so this is a website that I built to explain more about the topic hydraulics. As it has 10 pages of full information, this is the interview I did with Steve Richmond, and also I have a gallery here that just shows a few pictures that have to that connect with the topic hydraulics, and a timeline, which is right here. Like, put this background, though it's a little hard to read, but you can always visit the full site. Then, of course, there's going to be mysteries of hydraulics, and then we put this from the ancient times, like ancient China, ancient Rome, ancient Greece, those kinds of stuff. And we cannot forget about the economy as water towers. First of all, they use hydraulics as well. I mean, in a way, hydraulics is controls Earth. Like, we also got a few scientists some things that helped us to figure out more about the topic. And also, there's pneumatics, which sounds like hydraulics, but isn't. I just put pneumatics because it sounded like similar to hydraulics, but pneumatics works with air. Hydraulics works with liquids. And I put a little survey here in case you want to take it. And then the conclusion page.
So I know that you've been studying power and the generalization of power in your GATE class.
Yes.
How does what you studied connect to your learning about power?
Well, the power generalization I chose, the connections are right here. And power, the generalization I picked is power may be used or abused. Let's put this example into a crane. A crane uses hydraulics. And of course, you have the levers inside it that move. But if you abuse the power, then eventually hydraulics can become way powerful and destroy the building you're making. If you're using the power, then you can use the right things and put the right things and then like put it where you want to put it without destroying it.
So even though it's a machine, it's dependent upon human judgment.
Yes.
To use it well.
Yes.
You have also been studying about integrity.
Yes.
In your GATE class. How did you utilize integrity in your capstone?
I did not plagiarize. I copied a few words from websites, but it's not like I plagiarized a whole sentence, because then I would be just basically copying someone else's work when they were the ones that gave us the information. As a gifted learner, we can sometimes become very curious about the world around us. when we're curious about one topic, then we may just want to focus on that topic and learn more about it. Capstone can help us learn into a deeper thinking research with higher order thinking, and that way you can like discover more about the topic like I did here with the hydraulics.
So do you think you'll continue to further study of hydraulics?
Possibly, because in the future I could use a lot of jobs can use hydraulics, like engineering. If I pick one of those jobs and they ask me that I need to build something that uses that, then I'll know how it works and a lot of history about it, so then I won't struggle with it a lot. I think the capstone is one of the best projects you can use to learn whatever you want, because it can really help you for any situation you might need in the future.